friend is waiting for you to take a slice out of your nose.
No, do it by touch. You should best shave. My man shave. It's like eating. Don't need a mirror, do you? Open your mouth and it goes.
Fuck you.
Yes. You don't skew your lip on a fork, do you?
No.
It's a fair old razor, this. Who left it?
No one. I bought it.
Gentlemen call it.
So they don't have to go home in the middle of the night. I can't stand that.
I'll get back to that wife.
Oh, no. That's sweet. I like married men. They ring you up at midnight and say, can I come round? I like that.
You don't hang about, do you?
Well, if I like the look of something, I'll say so.
And get it?
Usually.
Have you ever been Laidlaw's girlfriend?
Mind your own business.
Yeah. Like having the light on. It's nice to know who you're with, isn't it? Well, he's a fair old pad, you know, for a secretary with a poor shorthand note.
Temps make £60 a week.
Smoked salmon in the fridge, Dutch tiles in a bathroom, shipping an old booze cupboard full of booze. There must have been £15,000 worth of goodies in this place.
It's my father, you fool.
Ah. Rich as well as posh, eh? Wish I had a dad like that. Do you get a private income as well?
Yes.
I wonder what would happen to me if I had all those advantages. Eton, Oxford. I probably would have ended up nicking the rowing trophies, wouldn't I?
What's your father like?
I don't know. Never met him. He went off my mother and my mother went off me. Spent a few years looking around for a randy old geezer that looked like me. Ended up working with Ozzie Jenkins. He's about the nearest to parents I got. I didn't do too well by him, by and large. Must be a bit of responsibility having parents. You're a dutiful daughter.
They take me as I am. And I am sorry about Ozzie Jenkins. I was a bit stuffy about that file.
To me, I was a bit nervous. I should have had a chat to you when I came out. I never seemed to find time. We had a bit of a bundle. And I never sorted it out with.
That's rotten.
That's why I know that the boss should have killed him. Anyway, you rich little raver, I'm taking you off to the country in my private aeroplane.
Oh. Sounds lovely. Where?
Where horses fart, blackbirds sing. So get your knickers on. Old Don hates us to be late. Now there is a potential father if ever there was one. And somehow he can't manage to pull a girl.
Ah, the celebrated Sergeant Bullman.
Celebrated?
Sit down.
I'm flattered, Major.
I wouldn't be. I've got a nasty reputation.
Really? I thought you were going to say I was in for the Nobel Prize. I'm looking into the death of Ozzie Jenkins.
Excellent. Talk to Inspector Dennis at Scotland Yard. He'll tell you everything I know about Dodson and Jenkins.
With all due deference to the inspector, Major, my questions are pertinent to a possible murder in my manner and a suitcase of lost files.
You're ahead with the coroner, Bullman. Perhaps you are after a Nobel Prize.
Will you help me?
If I can.
Well, I've got a list here of friends and former oppos of Jenkins. I want you to tell me which ones are members of Echo.
I can't do that.
When Jenkins went straight, he was dropped by all his old friends.
We encourage people to make new friends.
There were no new friends. He met Nora secretly, and I think he also met with other members of Echo. I just want you to tell me which ones they were.
How will that help you?
I don't know yet, but I'll get something.
Surely you will, but probably nothing to do with Jenkins.
Okay, Major. I just thought it was in your interest to get to the bottom of this.
It is, but I can't break confidence like that.
No. Important matter, confidence. I'm asking you about six names on this piece of paper. Warren, Barnes...
No. Confidence is everything at Echo. It's the basis on which we work. Anonymity and confidence.
There is a tie-up between a reformed cat burglar going for a swim in a concrete boot A civil servant scarping with a suitcase of records. So I can't feel too sensitive about the anonymity of 6 former criminals.
It's because of insensitive policemen like you, Bullman, that inquiries into my organization are discouraged.
It is a private, not an official organization, isn't it, sir?
Quite. Financed by myself. Despite that, it is an official instruction.
There are a lot of very nasty villains still on the streets, hiding behind instructions like that.
That is an impertinent intrusion and a deliberate disregard of your standing orders.
Okay, okay, Major, that's how you feel. I'll go.
I'm going to report you.
You can... You do what you like, Major.
You're going to be bounced, Bullman.
It's up to my governor, isn't it?
Bulldog Bullman. Hard man. I'm glad you came. They say you're a keen hand at the telephone directory, a big whack in the guts man.
That's the kind of slander your ex-cons put about. They don't deserve the trust you appear to have in them, could they?
You're on a fizzle, Bullman. I'm going to blast you from here to Kingdom Come.
Ah, marvellous!
It's lovely.
I really feel in charge of myself up here. Look up, look down. I could do your crossword in 2 minutes.
Oh, yes. Right then. 7 letters, Magoo's tongue.
Yeah, well, I could if I wanted. Do you know I once went up 8 floors of a Park Lane hotel? On the outside without a rope. Jumping from ledge to ledge. 100 feet up. It was fantastic.
What a clever spider you are.
Especially when I found Miss World's jewels in the wardrobe. I knew they were there. I just had to get there, that's all. I could have levitated myself the last 2 floors. I get a similar sort of sensation skin diving.
You like diving as well?
Oh, yeah, it's fantastic. Rapture of the deep. You a member of the Mile High Club? Have you ever made love in an aeroplane?
No, of course not.
What's that rapture of at 5,000 feet, eh? There's a crossword clue for you.
Heaven? Well, you're not going to try.
Why not?
Well, not with Don there.
He once knew a pilot used to knock off women passengers on scheduled flights into Heathrow. In the cockpit. Know what his technique was? He used to put his earphones over their ears like this. And then he'd lean forward.
They promised to send my leadless pewter beer tankard. I need that tankard, Warren. I still haven't got it.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, all very well for you to say yeah, but when? That tankard is unique. It lowers the temperature of the beer. It can get very hot in the Caucasus. I'll certainly need that. Made by John Mitchell of Derby.
Yeah, well, Ozzy will bring it to your dozen. Don't worry.
There's other things, too.
Like your copper frying pan, no doubt.
I want to speak to Ozzy, then.
Yeah, well, you can't, yeah.
Have you still got that list I gave you? Because I want all the items on that list. If you sell me short, Warren, I'll tell Reisen.
Look, you'll need a cabin trunk for the gear on that list. You're flying, not going on a Queen Mary.
No, I've worked it out. A couple of suitcases will suffice.
Yeah, noted. Now, look, do me a favour, Dodson, will you? Leave me alone. Come read your dirty magazines. That's a good fella.
I have not finished yet.
All right, here we go. Hold on to your hat, girl.
And another thing.
No.
Yes. You were supposed to supply me with a woman.
Food, drink and sex. That's all you think about, doesn't it? You're worse than an animal at the zoo. You're disgusting.
I resent that. Jesus Christ!
How about that? What the hell do you think you're playing at?
Buzzing Charlie Warren.
It's 152 meters. They're making speed 40 km/h. Which makes 152 multiplied by 1,000.
Reisen, yes.
Yes, Major. Yes, well, I'm very busy for the moment. Okay. Yes, back of the house as usual. Can you give me 20? Bye. Damn and blast. Rod Gatherall's not a state visit.
All right, Don? Happy landing?
Just watch it.
How do you feel, baby?
Oh, all right when I get my stomach back.
There's a kiss.
If a fella can't have a bit of fun on his day off, then you can stick it, Don, because I don't want to know.
I could show you aerobatics would make your ears smoke, Sonny Jim. You're just not good enough.
I own half of this machine.
Okay, go ahead. Kill yourself. Show off to your girlfriend, but not while I'm riding shotgun, okay? I'm going to kip for an hour, and then I'm flying you back.
Nice little riot in Birmingham last night, Reisen.
Not bad for an Indian takeaway.
Very effective. Made at least a paragraph in all the nationals. Two policemen hurt, 5 parkies arrested. Who set it up for us?
Vauxhall Peter.
Send him a bonus. How's the airport?
All set and ready to go. Just waiting for you to fix up the decoy. My man up north's handling our security. And by the way, Warren did a good job for us.
He usually does. Now it's best to work fast. Is the sail set?
Chinese team. Hard dealers, mind you. Christ, they're hard.
But reliable.
Prefer the Greeks myself, Major.
Stick to the Chinese, Reisen. Great men. Traditionalists. Chinese and Koreans, the Scots and Irish of the Orient. Best bandits in the world. Without fear or scruple. Ran the worst prison camps known to man. If you were a naughty boy with Johnny Jap, he handed you over to the Koreans. Ah. I want to kill Bullman.
You what?
I don't like him.
His own mother doesn't like him, but he'd be a dangerous man to chop.
He's a dangerous man to have around, and he knows too much.
He knows nothing. Bullman's a tea leafer, too thick. Kids in sweet shops, that's his collar.
He's unscrupulous and overbearing.
Granted, but let's leave it till after the job. I think that's favourite, Major.
Perhaps you're right. I think I'll report him to the commissioner.
That's right, Major. Have him on the carpet. Now, it's Scott I'm worried about. He's a silly bastard, but he's clever. And he's really jumping over Ozzie Jenkins.
I'm handling Spider Scott.
That bit of see you, Spider. Look, drop in, fall out of the sky, drink my wine and shoot my pigeons, you're welcome, but don't ask me questions.
Well, what's so big, eh? Tell me.
Anything is big with questions. I have to remember, and memory is work, and that's forbidden to me.
This is me, Charlie. Spider. The one that used to climb in through the window with your bacon sandwiches while you were opening the safe. Remember?
Major, over forgive me for that.
Anything that's from about you is a spiel you're giving me. Now, come on, I'm not missing.
You make me wish I'd never known you, Spider. Look, I'm settled down. I'm a member of Echo. Laidlaw introduces me to these rich society punters who buy my paintings. But how in hell that qualifies him as being the most dangerous man in England? Well, or even connects him with old Aussies, that was something I can't answer, son. So come out of my nose and leave it alone.
Here, there's a girl over here.
Has he been out yet today?
No, not yet.
Oh, didn't I fit, darling?
far too big, Charlie. I'll keep my jeans on, but I'll borrow the crop.
Yeah, well, they belong to my sister's kid. And she goes out with this Greek geezer who thinks they're nothing but catapis. I mean, what do you expect? She has got a bottle like the Curtles. Anyway, that's life. He likes it.
Thanks, anyway.
What's all that?
She said no more cuddles for you unless you go horse riding with her. Anyway, I've got a wool jumper out there. It might break your neck.
Not today, Charlie, no.
Come on, then. You're going.
No, I want to talk to Charlie.
Oh, all right, then.
Work the Oracle, Sarge.
The Oracle worked me over, Willis.
Oh, yeah?
Slapped my wrist severely, Willis.
If it's any consolation, Jerry Summers got an official rep after he saw him.
Well, he's reporting me, he says. Calculated risk. It's happened before, it'll happen again.
Powerful friend, Sarge. They say he's got half a Whitehall in his pocket.
What did Summers see him about?
Oh, 2 years ago, checking missing persons against Echo membership.
Yeah, dead end.
Yeah, right.
Beautiful. I've got a connection there. You drive. A little theory. We're going to see Corpse at the mortuary. His theory might well hold some water.
No, I won't tell you who that man was. You've made me irritated, Spider. But I'm sticking my neck out and I'm telling you something that is nothing but a warning to a friend. This business is big banana, son.
Paul! International secret selling.
Yeah, listen and forever hold your peace. Since that Chinese legation caper of yours, there's citizens about believe you've teamed up with the odd lot. Influential people, Spider, straight. You're not welcome. And there's others say you're a planted grass.
Well, they can say what they like.
Well, you want to learn this world is a very worrying and godless place. Living is a complicated business. There's only one thing that's certain right now. You're either alive or dead. I've always held you in high esteem. I mean, you was a lovely creeper. Respected a real commando. So use your life. Relate to people. No one potato is an island, Spider. Pull! Lay off.
Ozzie Jenkins didn't.
You got the message, son. Now go and rejoice and you're still in one piece.
Paul!
Oh, I was rather boring.
Listen, Corpse, you horrible, creepy little necrophile. I want you to tell me and my kicker here what you were telling Spider Scott the other day on the ID.
Was that concrete boot?
That's right. Mm.
Oh, my governor's doubtful on the evidence, Sarge.
Asking about your governor, I'm asking you. You said you'd never seen a concrete boot before because they don't come up. But what does come up? Remind me.
Stone and rope jobs. Plenty of them. There's chain and metal jobs. I mean, with the oxidisation, they're common enough.
Something unusual, of course. It occurred to me that you said something very significant the other day.
Did I?
You did, and I'm asking your advice.
That's very handsome of you, Sarge.
You said it was a ritual execution for grassing. Would you know any more of that ilk in your wide experience?
What do you mean, not just the swimmers in?
Anything.
Disposed of. Well, it's usually dismembering. I get any number of stray arms and legs, even the odd head.
Well, I'm not dismembering, something original.
Well, one minute, hang about. About the old M1, the motorway. I was thinking it was a couple of years back now, an Arctic crashed into one of the bridges. I found a geezer in a concrete.
No, that's a load of old cobblers. They thought it was Blossom Longlands.
Hello? Same gimmick as a concrete boot, really. Only they call this one Home of Your Own.
Blossom Longlands was a grass.
Well, I've heard them say that there's bodies in bridges along the M1 all the way to Sheffield.
What did Charlie do to you, Spider? You should have come for a ride. It was great. What were you two talking about all that time?
Echo? Ozzie Jenkins? The rising price of Master Prince? Do you know a pair of Kellos went for £800 the other day and it wasn't even Bond Street?
Why don't you come back to the Major's for tea? I've got to put an appearance because Lady Tyler's dedicating our new hostel tonight, and there are a few things to go over. Well, maybe I'll ask you along. It could be fun.
Yeah, if it's with you.
I'll cook you some dinner afterwards.
Tea for Diggo.
Here you are, old man. I'm only allowed warm milk, peptic ulcer, so I eat by proxy. Fortunately, we both adore cucumber sandwiches. No, the main thing for a chap in your boots is to find a new personal identity. That's the way to re-establish yourself in society. Recast your life. Don't muck about with thieves. Have nothing whatever to do with your past.
That's easier said than done.
Police past, criminal past. Rather like giving up smoking. No. We can keep the old bill off your back if you behave yourself. We've got a team of damn good lawyers to see to that. And we can help you to try to make new friends, establish business contacts.
Yeah?
We haven't done too badly so far. Every eligible young man in the country is after Penny.
Yes, my trouble is, I hate joining anything.
Well, you use us, that's all. Sometimes we use you. Mutual convenience. Now, you have an airplane. Our members and associates often have flying business for a competitive price.
Sort of Masonic guild, is it?
If you like. And we have other benefits, like insurance, house mortgage facilities. That's if you need them, but you're pretty well set up compared to most of the chaps we deal with. And no spankers. I think we do a pretty good job.
Seems like it, yeah.
And we don't have many lapses, like Ozzie Jenkins. Perhaps because we dislike the fist of the law as much as you do. We're in the same reform business all round. Huh? Enjoy your nursery tea, children.
I told you.
That all seems a bit too cute to me.
Your trouble is you don't like anybody wanting to help you.
Right. I like to help myself. Laylaw reminds me of a bent screw. And Warren isn't nice. Or a sweetie. He's a scared little schnook.
Who is it?
Widow Thomas, dear. A friend. Oh, hello, my dear. Is Spider Scott at home?
No, he's not.
Oh. Oh, well, I was in the manor, giving a music lesson, like, and I thought, Spider lives round the corner. I'll just pop in, dear. You're Maggie Parsons. Yes. You don't remember me, but we have met. No, you don't, do you? No, no, no. Well, I'm Nora. Yes. Spider Scott's old mum, in a manner of speaking.
Yeah, well, we met at that birthday party.
Muscle Terry's coming out, dear. Oh, excuse me, dear, but could I use your toilet? I'm breaking my neck for a gypsy.
Of course.
Now, Freezer picks up our airport control van at the terminal building. Bay 42?
42, yeah.
Right. Now, where are you, Rod?
Me?
Yes, you, Rod.
In a car, he doing me Barney.
After putting on your overalls.
Yeah.
11:55, you and Simmy over to the van. Bide your time, just chat away to Freezer through the window. You're waiting for the plane to come in.
Oh, that's no problem.
Now, we all know about the plane. We've got the details. We'll know if it's changed. 12:05 from Munich, BAC 111. That's brilliant. Bay 43. Courier's first off, carries the gear in a brown attache case. Now, it's heavier than you think, so don't let him put it on your head. Watch it, Freezer.
Right.
Met by two security men. They're easy meat. A bit of muscle will soon sort them out. Hit the courier.
Bang!
No, not bang. Just a tap rod. We don't want Clara all over the tarmac. A clean job. That's it. And by this time, the whole airport will be in such a state of confusion with our little decoy.
Yeah, we hope.
I'm telling you, it's an A1 dud, or you'll be out to the handover like Jack's rabbit.
Yeah, but it's still tricky.
You're a professional pessimist, Freezer. Now you just keep your cap pulled down, and at $5,000 apiece, you're on easy street.
$5,000 apiece?
He always was wicked with the girls.
It's not just that, Nora. You never know where you are with him. Never mind. Let's forget it.
All right, then, dear. Let's have one similar, then I'll be on my bike. Shall I do the honours?
Oh, look, don't say anything, please.
Oh, my lips are sealed.
Hello, Nora.
Hello, darling.
What are you doing here? I thought you'd gone home to your mother's.
Yes, I was, till I couldn't get any answers to my phone calls last night.
Who's been a naughty boy then? Dirty little stop out. I'm ashamed of you, Spider.
Kicked me out, didn't she?
I was ringing to apologise.
Oh, I am sorry.
I think you're well shot of him, dear.
That's my business.
Oh, sorry I spoke.
She's got a message for you. Mm.
And private, if you don't mind.
Oh, Christ!
Funny girl. Are you sure she's good enough for you, Spider, dear?
Who is?
Oh, surely now you can do better than that. Never have a woman what cries, dear.
Hmm. What do you want, Nora?
Mr. Dodson called.
Dodson?
Yes, Ozzy's Dodson. I didn't like to tell you, but we had a little set-up going. Well, I mean, you were so close to Ozzy, I didn't like to that night. You see, me and Mr. Dodson used to meet over in Chiswick once a week. And he called me on the trumpet just after, said he was coming up to London tonight. Could I go over there? Well, for a farewell one.
Why are you telling me?
Well, it might be my farewell one, like Ozzy. Now, look, Spider, I don't know what's going on, but I'm frightened. I've had your Bullman to see me. I've had your Reisen to see me. There's something going on and, well, I ain't up to aggravation.
Not setting me up, are you, Nora?
On my baby's head.
Give me the address.
Oh, all right. Here it is, dear. Look, side door, 8:30. He says he's going to be on his own because all the rest are going to a party. Now, look, I only want to know what happened to my Ozzy.
Why didn't you tell Bullman?
I can't cry, Law.
No.
Mr. Dodson had give me £10.
Yeah, all right, Nora.
Oh, ta.
There you go.
Mm.
Well, Nora,
mm-hmm.
You'll put me on a stoomer. I shall have to smack your bottom. You know that, don't you? Come on.
I've got no change, Doris. But no change, Derek. Well, Dawson's in the papers.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, just a paragraph here. Civil servant absconds. Files believed missing. What did you find out?
Lawson was clean official for 2 years. Working at Battersea Power Station. Last lag in the island, 73.
Hmm. No doubt ends up supporting a bridge on the motorway. I like it. It doesn't make sense. All right.
He was a heavy National Front man, often around in the trouble.
Yeah, incitement.
Never made it stick.
Oh, good lad. There's something there. I can feel it in my water.
Give us a connection, Sarge. A flashier Einstein.
Yeah. You ever heard of a Greek called Euclid, Willis?
Not Big Gregorio, the presser from Camden Town.
No. This one lived in Alexandria about 2,000 years ago.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, and he was the expert on connections. Now, you could say he was Einstein's master. He was the big daddy of them all. And do you know what, Willis?
What's that?
He had himself castrated so he could think clearer.
Yeah?
Yeah. Had him off down there for the sake of it up here.
That's a bit heavy, Sarge.
Yes. I think it is. Now, about these files.
You sit there sulking? Why don't you go home to your mother's? I'll give you a ring. When it's all over. Like we arranged.
Yeah. You're tired of knocking off that toffee-nosed tark. Echo, whatever you call it. Big deal. Don's sick of you too.
Well, Don can mind his own business.
Everything's got to revolve around you. You just do what you like.
You'll do plenty for other people, don't you worry?
Yeah, I bet you do plenty for Apeny, Ed.
Hello, may I speak to Spider, please?
Come off it, Meg.
Sleeping with her was one thing, but I think it was really mean of you taking her up in your aeroplane. You never take me.
I have?
Twice, nowhere nice. What about that trip you got to Latuke tomorrow?
It's a business trip. Now, you know I can't take on business trips. It's very important. Don thinks we might get a contract out of it.
Yeah, I bet she'll go, she asks. Oh, Spider, don't go. Please stay. Look, I'll get a bottle of wine and we'll watch telly in bed and snuggle up to you. It'd be lovely.
Look, I've got to go. So why don't you go home to your mother's, eh? Before you get too drunk to drive.
Yeah, because you're not coming back.
Well, I probably am, but not till late. I don't know, do I?
Oh, you bastard! I'll finish with you. On your done over. Your gangster pals have you killed.
Oh, thanks. And don't start crying again, for God's sake. It's life accepted. I can never be what you want me to be, all right?
I just want you to be a bit like it.
Oh, come on, baby. Look, she's due to pick me up in a minute. So why don't you give one of your girlfriends a phone and have her over and play some records, but don't get drunk on your own.
Get off. I do what I like. Get out, I don't want her in here.
Well, I didn't know you'd be here, did I?
Get out!
You better leave about two and don't let Rod drive because he's a bloody maniac. Yes? Yes, Major? Yes, the decoy. Hire an aeroplane and use Spider Scott. Yes? Oh, in his own aeroplane. That's a brilliant idea, Major. A very brilliant idea. I'll send a couple of the chaps round to collect him from the party. Cheers.
Thank you. you don't want to spend the evening listening to speeches, that you would rather partake of all these delicious refreshments. But I would like to thank all these captains of industry who have contributed so generously towards the restoration of this hostel.
Yeah, yeah. Here we are.
And finally, Mr. Chairman, I must commend you and your staff at Echo for the unique contribution you've made through your unstinting work to a major social problem. Honesty and rehabilitation through social involvement has given scores of former criminals the incentive they needed to become good and worthy citizens again. Men without bitterness. Men joined in a common aim under the banner of Echo to make Britain great once more.
Yeah, well said.
It is a great honor and a great pleasure to me to inaugurate this hostel and dedicate it to the future of rehabilitation.
If you're standing firmly here, it is, yeah.
Really?
I was just thinking of a friend of mine.
Yes.
He hated the water.
Champagne, Lady Tyler. Major.
Cheers. This is Charlie Arkney, Lady Tyler, one of our staff members. 21 years in prison before he joined us.
Yeah, proper villain I am.
Now he's a foreman sewage operative with the GLC.
Really? And are you happy in your work?
Well, I keep the effluvium moving, lady, and I kill the rats. Because your handbags all swimming about in the effluvium. Of course, we're meant to poison them, but that don't seem to do much good, so I smash them with my shovel.
Really?
Yeah, that sorts them out. Last week I was bitten in the throat, and yesterday this big brown...
You're all right. Carry on, Charlie.
Interesting fellow.
Oh, salt of the earth, old Charlie. A real communist hater. There hasn't been a single work stoppage in the East London division since he's been down there.
Oh, he's a good chap. I could see that.
Record, Charlie, how's it going, my old son?
Oh, I could murder a pint.
What are you doing with this lot, then, eh?
Well, I'm converted, Spider.
Everything's all right, then?
Yeah, what? Lovely flat in Bethnal Green on Echo Mortgage, life insurance and a smashing boyfriend works for the BBC. It's my pupsy, darling. He don't even shave.
Excuse me. I'm sorry.
Yes. Feed us one of those, Spider, while the governor's not looking.
Well, sure you don't bite off the glass, won't you?
Tastes like puke.
Yeah, too right.
Hey, why didn't you tell me you're coming? I would have given you a lift down in the aeroplane.
Oh, no, that's all right. I want to drive back tonight. I'd like to be independent. Spider, I'm glad you've joined us. You won't regret it.
Well, thanks for putting up with me this morning. You gave me some very good advice.
It's a pleasure, sir. Here's a love.
There's a whisper over there. Yeah. Last time I saw him, it was in the strong room at Harry's.
Excuse me.
Not bad for me.
Mr. Scott, I'd like to meet Lady Tyler, President of the Penal Reform Association, Mr. William Scott.
How do you do?
Mr. Scott is a former cat burglar and an XYY man.
That's right, yeah.
Very interesting. What do you feel about the chromosome theory yourself?
Well, I don't know, really.
I mean, do you find it difficult to sublimate your criminal urges?
Not really, as long as I have plenty of women.
That's most interesting.
Yeah, and most enjoyable, too, yes. A lot more interesting than burglary. But would you excuse me? I must get a drink.
Two on the snotter, nail varnish in the Yankee, and what's his name?
Rintintin.
That's the one.
Hey, Wrecker, could you tell me where the Benghazi is?
Yeah, through the doors, down the stairs, straight ahead. Smart gents. Oh, yeah, miss. He went to the powder room.
Earn yourself £10.
Sorry, mate. She's not for sale.
No, not for that. Get me to Hampstead in 15 minutes. All right. Ace. Sorry, lad. That's your lot for tonight.
You bleeder.
Give him your lid.
You've got a bleeding cheek.
Don't argue, as I'll thump
you. You are. Buy yourself an ice cream.
Not in the Kazi.
Cool.
Lively.
If you just hang about a bit round the back, there'll be a bit of bunt in it for you.
Right.
All right?
Good.
Come on, my son.
Is that you, Nora?
You lucky old bastard. Now you tell me about Ozzy Jenkins, right?
Reisen's gonna go potty about this.
Reisen? What about the Major? We've got to get him. Come on, put some down.
I really didn't know about Ozzy. I swear I didn't know. I'm shocked. Well, it spoils my plans. We were to meet tomorrow on the plane. That was the deal they promised.
Where?
Well, up north.
Where was the plane going?
Amsterdam, and from there we were catching the Soviet in-tourist excursion to Moscow.
You better give yourself up, hadn't you?
Well, I can't not. Why?
A bloody defector, man.
What absolute rubbish. Of course I'm not.
Well, what are you?
Well, I stole a few personal files from the National Records Office, that's all. Nothing to do with Russia. I haven't any secrets to tell the Russians. Ossie Jenkins and I were going to retire there.
Retire to Russia?
Well, why not?
Well, it's not quite like emigrating to Australia, is it?
Well, what do you know about it, huh? Georgia in the Caucasus? Have you ever been there? It's paradise on earth. It's where they first domesticated the vine. It's where men live to be 125 years old and have 16-year-old mistresses on their 100th birthday.
You're crazy.
What's so crazy about wanting that? I've been planning this for years. I've spent my holidays there. I've got a house.
A house?
There's a dacha in a beautiful valley near Suhumi. You've no idea what it's like. Oh, wine, 5p a litre, some wonderful air and food. Well, olives and stone ground flour, every vegetable under the sun, kid baked with rosemary. And those women, my God, those marvellous black-eyed women. I'll be rich anything I want, you see? Yes, except I'll need to find a new cook now. Poor Ossie, I was going to buy him a wife.
You got money there?
Well, of course. All my life savings and what I sold the files for. I'll be a prince, it's been my dream.
Who did you sell the files to, Laidlaw?
I can't tell you.
Well, Ozzy knew.
Yes, but you mustn't ask me now. Please go away. Oh, go away.
What makes you think they'll let you emigrate to Russia?
Well, that was the bargain. Besides, I can't do them any harm over there. Civil servant defects, there's the end of it. Oh, I've made my plans.
Be the end if they fixed you up in a concrete boot, wouldn't it?
It is all arranged.
Now, come on. You tell me who those files were on. I won't say anything till after you've left the country. Now, come on, you tell me. Well,
they were master files. I was processing the material to go into the computer. It was easy enough to steal them.
Who were they on?
Criminals.
Who?
Well, some were Scotland Yard masters, and there was one American one. That was part of the new FBI link-up. I could have destroyed your file for you, Scott.
What was the FBI link-up all about, eh?
Look, please go away. I've got some money upstairs. I've got cash, £500.
Oh, you tell me who those files were on, how Laidlaw was involved, right?
I can't tell you, no.
Now, you tell me!
I haven't said anything, Warren. I swear, I haven't said
Spider.
Mr. Reisen wants a word in your tiny ear.
I've got a job for you tomorrow, Spider.
Oh, yeah?
Grand if you do it.
Concrete boot if I don't.
Oh, you'll do it.